Revelations of massive corruption by the Office of the Auditor General within government departments has yet again validated suspicions of the never-ending circle of corruption in government.
It's the argument that I cannot be the cook and not taste the broth. The politicians of the day or the people in power reward the people who supported them with jobs, contracts, and special concessions.
It is against this backdrop that State House disclosed yesterday that Nairobi and Washington have jointly developed a master plan to root out corruption within government ranks, a move a number of observers have hailed as a huge demonstration of commitment by the head of state.
President Uhuru Kenyatta is very much of late trying to cut a niche for himself, to break from the pack, and sort of show that over and above just being Jubilee and an ordinary president, he wants to leave a mark in the country.
However, others believe this may not yield much.
That support will become a cropper if the nation, as a nation, involving the citizenry and the leadership, do not take this war head-on on our own.
The partnership will involve strengthening of institutions charged with a mandate to root out graft, but on this one, observers hold the view that the two governments must look beyond the current systemic bottlenecks.
This country has adequate legal framework for combating corruption. No sooner do we have this country make a move to combat or to deal with a corrupt incident than corruption fights back, than investors and sympathizers of corruption and the corrupt kick in and again frustrate the war.
It's about giving them the necessary resources, human and material resources, as well as the technological know-how and resource capability that would allow them to, bring forth factual investigative findings.
According to the two analysts, the war on graft will only end once the citizenry and its leadership wage a credible onslaught against the sleaze in equal proportion.
Once corruption becomes a lifestyle like it appears it is, then fighting it becomes anathema.
When someone is driving home, when someone needs a small service out there, there's a tendency to want to, to converse, to want to part with something. And all these things resonate up to the top, actually, up to the echelons of society.
But to effectively end the cancer of corruption, Stephen Musyoka believes it's time to outsource a body to fight it.
The United States of America perhaps needed to actually install a foreign body to combat corruption. As long as it is a Kenyan national in the ethics and anti-corruption, who has been vetted by our own parliament, the bulk of whom have got that position through the vice, it becomes impossible.
Eric Biegon reporting for Channel One News.